This is a video to help you permanently fix procrastination. Not for a week, not for a month, for good. I've spent 13 years of my life researching consistency, high performance, and goal achievement to learn what eventually became the Iron Will Method. In this video, you're going to get everything you need. So be assured, if you've been struggling with procrastination, like I used to for many years, the buck stops here. You're going to be good, provided you just listen and apply, you're going to be good. My recommendation is watch this video a few times, once or twice. Take the actions that are outlined and apply it for 30 days. I promise you, you'll have the most productive month you've had in years. And then you'll know. Let's dig into it. Okay, everything you need in one guide. My background is going to be covered in this video. My background with procrastination, it was really, really fucking bad actually, and severe anxiety that drove a lot of that. Reassurance to you that you, just like I had to, can get out of procrastination hell forever and live a life of achievement, success, abundance. It is great, and you can do it. And how you can do that using the Iron Will Method. So this is all free. Everything you need is in here. It's based on nature's laws. It's based on biology, circadian principles, project management. And I'm going to explain to you why you procrastinate, as well as the mindset shifts that you need to put in place. And I'm going to give you a roadmap that's going to tell you the two keys to put this together. So by the end of this, you've got everything you need step by step. Let's get into it. My background with procrastination and severe anxiety. So whilst I'm a handsome 6'5" stud of a male now, I'm joking. This is the background I came from. I was severely anxious, had very low self-esteem, low self-worth, looked awful, had bad style, didn't believe in myself, and unfortunately had developed really bad work habits and ended up being a massive, massive procrastinator. Needless to say, this damaged my outcomes in life. This did real damage to me. This meant that I was underachieving hugely. Despite seeming to do some of the right things, I just couldn't stick to things for long enough to produce proper outcomes in consistency. These things I've seen just wreck and ravage lives again and again. It's now my mission to share with you everything I learned that allowed me to slay this dragon once and for all. So rest assured, I've been there. Why I couldn't break through in my life and get to the next level was I couldn't fully change my self-image to be an action taker. I couldn't change my brain fully to get consistent. I'd do all these self-help workshops. I'd go to retreats. I'd do all these different things, read the books, take the courses. Nothing fucking worked until I started asking the question, why? And importantly, studied high performers, looked at the best in the world and asked the question, if point A is where I am and point B is where they are, how can I close the gap? And I'm going to get into all of that and how I deconstructed it. Very simple stuff, actually. And guess what? All free. So, because I hadn't built the proper psychological foundation and didn't have the right neural real estate, regardless of what I did or what my goals were, I couldn't stick to them and I couldn't manifest them in the world. I couldn't make them happen. I struggled with my weight, struggled with health problems, brain fog, low mood, depression, anxiety, low self-esteem. My image was poor. Things were falling apart for me. And the reason for this, I now know, is the conditioning that had taken place in my brain, that took place through life. The habits, the one-second decisions I'd make, the adaptations that I created through my behaviors. Inadvertently, I put myself in the dungeon of procrastination and ended up in procrastination hell. until I use my intelligence and determination to get out. The intangibles then, what actually holds us back? Because you know, you can take two people, give them the same task, give them the same goal. One's going to get to the end of 2024, having accomplished it. The other, going to spin their wheels and do jack shit. What's the difference? It's the intangibles. It's what's going on underneath the surface. I'm going to get into that. But it's the unseen factors that separate us. And these are all built within. Neural pathways, subconscious habits, ways of being, mindsets that are internalized and ingrained. More on that in this presentation. So, reassurance. Listen, I'm going to start because I know this is a powerful and evocative topic that might be emotional for some. Procrastination, I understand, causes real suffering in the world. It causes people to live limited lives where they just don't put their head above the parapet, where they go by for years a wallflower standing in the background whilst everyone else gets success and gets on in their life. And it was me, and it hurt me bad. It did damage to my psychology. It hurt me. It caused me unbelievable pain to know I wasn't living my human potential. It was bad for me. And I was a hardworking chap. You know, I got my first job at 11, like 5 paper rounds at 11, 2 jobs at 16. I was driven. I was motivated. Wanted to be someone. Went to an excellent university at 18. Achieved well academically. All of that. But underneath all of that, inconsistency through everything. And it was repetition of that that ultimately put me where I was. At age 24, I was a housebound agoraphobic with severe clinical anxiety, 5 panic attacks a day. My life was a living hell. Everything fell apart. I gained huge amounts of weight, became obese, developed a litany of health problems, chronic fatigue, brain fog, low mood, anxiety, of course, just unbelievable, murderous anxiety. I wasn't functioning, man. Things, insomnia, incredibly bad insomnia. Nothing was working. There were so many problems within me that it seemed like it would take up multiple lifetimes to correct them. And the only way out I could really think was, rather, you've got to find a way to rejuvenate and restore the whole human being. You've got to find ways to heal every aspect of yourself. There must be something in this world that can take a broken human and fix them. And I eventually, when I was in the depths of this dungeon, I had these fuck it moments. When I was truly suffering from anxiety and just looking at all this laundry list of problems that meant that I was at 24, like living with my parents, without a job, unable to function, like so fat and so anxious and so sick and destroyed inside. I remembered that, dude, I was a productive, intelligent, like, guy, what's happened to me? What the fuck has gone so wrong? It was those very dark nights of the soul in a very somber state that I started to ask myself, dude, what if you could be successful? What if not only you could take yourself from this impossible situation where you've got all these problems? I'm sitting there, man, with slipped discs, herniated discs in my spine, obese, anxious, brain fog. I can't function. I can't think. I can't do anything. I can't get out of bed. I've got chronic fatigue. I've had so many horrendous, traumatic experiences. I've been so lonely. I've never been on a date. I've had all these self-esteem issues. And these fuck it moments were, dude, what if you could make it? What if you, from this impossible situation, dealt these impossible hands, could go and become extremely successful? What would it say about you, that you turned it around, and who would be inspired by you? What would your story empower other beings who are in the depths of this dungeon to do with their lives? That's what made me rise up. What drove me to get out of that hell was, Ravi, if you find the strength to get out of this, there's going to be others who will look to you and they will do the same. That gave me the strength to embark on 16 hours a day of research, extensive, expensive trial and error. I used a scientific method. I tested aggressively, literally tried everything out there. Attended workshops, masterminds, different coaches, different mentors, tried all different schools of thought, all different diets like ketosis, high carb, low carb, repeat, biohacking, Dr. Jack Cruz, mental, emotional healing, spiritual healing, different modalities, EFT, meditation, mindfulness, transcendental meditation, visualization, you name it, journaling, affirmations, like spiritual practices, going to spiritual healers. I tried everything. But I learned nuggets and little pieces of wisdom. And within my brain, things were crystallizing. I saw some things were working and some things were not making much difference. Ultimately, that burning question, is there a way that a human who's so broken can become whole? I need something that's going to fix everything, like that's going to help me heal everything. It can't just be, well, this will help you heal your inflammation, this will help you heal your insomnia. I needed a way to level up my entire systemic biology, and I found it. It was biohacking, decoding nature's law. I looked at excellence. I looked at people who had the most energy, the most vibrance, the most health. And what allowed them to do that was they live with nature's law. Their cells and their mitochondria were working really, really well. Their brain chemistry was really, really optimized. Their sleep was really, really optimized. Their level of body and brain oxygenation was solid. And as such, they could perform effortlessly and have success. When I understood that, and I understood that if you optimize the mitochondria and live in alignment with nature's laws, then nature will respect you. And regardless how fucked up you are, once you start to respect nature's laws, it will heal you because we're part of nature. The body will fix itself. Once you do the right things, you nail everything, the body will organize, it will activate its own inner healing mechanisms, and it will go to homeostasis. And sure enough, I did it. So that's how I learned a lot of what I know. And that was what allowed me to get out of procrastination and anxiety hell. Fighting back. The nightmare ends now. Firstly, I want you to recognize that you're not in this world to suffer. This isn't some sort of sick joke from God to torment you and to make you feel awful. You're in this world to thrive. You're in this world to go on a mission, to raise your level of competence and be successful so you can have impact and you can live how you want to live. With love, with joy, supporting other humans, being a positive force for good in this world. And all you're going through now is the universe giving you an opportunity to learn the deeper lessons of humanity in the world. Okay? So now, to fight back, you need to understand, what is driving this? Why do you suffer? Okay. Procrastination is essentially fed by three things. Mental and emotional stress, which promotes long-standing fight or flight responses, which trap your body in a low energetic state where it believes there's threats imminent in the environment. And when your biology thinks there's a saber-toothed tiger in the room, it will do anything to get you to try and find the danger, to scatter your focus, to put you all over the place. Because your mental and emotional stress levels are elevated, that's going to continuously keep you in this stressed, agitated, vigilant state. And as such, your body and brain is going to conspire against you to resist focusing because it will prioritize your survival above everything else. Next factor is your energy. As you go through living in the stress state for an extended period of time, your energy becomes depleted. You have less body and brain energy available, because inflammation is present, stress hormones are present in your bloodstream for extended periods of time, your system starts to downregulate and you just operate worse. And that sort of feeds the cycle. As your brain chemistry becomes depleted, as you have less vigor in yourself, you're less apt to actually mount the energetic response, overcome the resistance, and break the cycle and the loop. So it becomes really embedded, and you start to live at a lower level where you're less engaged with the world and you're taking less action in the world. And then comes the final piece that really creates long-term issues. You start to get stagnant. Yeah, when your brain and body start to get bored and you're not really thriving and you're not applying yourself and going out there and taking action and living your dreams and living your life expanded, rather you start living contracted. That's when all these things start to become an unconscious pattern, a loop, a behavioral loop, and homeostasis builds around it. You habituate it. Boom, you are in the dungeon and you will be there for years because of what conditioning happened in your brain. I hope that makes sense, but it's going to be clearer throughout the course of this video. So that's you understanding what happened within your brain that meant that regardless of whether you want to get something done or what your goals might be, they're just not happening. It's because of these subtle subconscious adaptations that take place that mean you just make the 1 second decisions to lean into your conditioning, which is what all animals do. So then the question becomes, how do we break this cycle? All right. First of all, if you're going to make any significant change, the first thing you need to do, what is it, guys? Have a think. You have to take personal responsibility. You've done this to yourself. No one else, you. There may have been difficult factors that precipitated it. You may have had, like I did, an incredibly tumultuous and difficult life. But guess what? That's now done. You now get to decide who you want to be, where you want to go, and what your future is. The only person who can turn you around is you. But guess what? You may have been lost before this video, and this may have been a lot of your life up till now. You can't blame yourself for being lost because you didn't have the roadmap. I've spent a lot of time, trial and error, huge investment of energy to produce this roadmap, and now you have it. Because you know you have the roadmap now, you now have it. Because you now have the roadmap, you will succeed. In fact, you can't fail. Once you've internalized this, watch it as many times as you have to. Once you've internalized it and it's truly made sense and the penny's dropped, your success is absolutely inevitable. Believe me, I've seen it time and time again. 700,000 people read my daily journal. Do you think almost 1 million people can be wrong? The answer to that is no. So, you now have the roadmap. Even if you failed before, that's fine. Success is never a linear path. It's trial and error. So now you found the roadmap. It's time to start Iron Will. All right. The Iron Will method, decoding nature's law, turning procrastination into performance. For you to turn this around, you need to get to the root, to the core, and rewire yourself. You will not solve this problem operating at the same level you've operated at. Again, this problem will not be solved operating at the level you've always operated at. In order to break this pattern and break this cycle, you're going to need to become the next evolution of yourself. But that's okay, because that is what nature wants. That's what your genes are designed for. And that is what you, myself, and everyone else gets when they go through the Iron Will method. Your biology then. You're going to have to reduce your stress hormones. In order to effectively break the cycle, you're going to have to get your body out of the survival stress state. It can take a bit of time. That's fine. It has to be done. For you to thrive, you're going to have to be energetic, balanced, calm, to the greatest extent that you can, to give yourself the highest likelihood of effectiveness in this world. There is no excuse. For not optimizing your biology, wherever you may be, there is no excuse that I'll accept, because this stuff is actually free. So you're going to recharge your biology and you're going to level up your brain and body performance. How we're going to do this is by recharging our cells at the level of the mitochondria and allowing our internal healing mechanisms to bring us into balance again. I'm going to explain to you how. Very simple stuff. Next step is systems. You can't allow your conditioning to run the show. If you've been a procrastinator for many, many years, understand that your conditioning and your psychological foundation is utterly inappropriate. You picked up bad habits from childhood. You've imprinted things into your brain that are now going to hold you back. And you have to rebuild your psychological foundation. This is subconscious. It's not on the surface. It's not on your conscious mind. Your conscious mind can be motivated and driven. Your internal conditioning is 80%. The iceberg analogy applies here. If so much of you is primed and predisposed to seeking comfort and just not applying yourself and staying in the comfort zone, then you're going to battle that and endlessly. How we can start to turn that around is through systems and structure. Day blocks, deep work sessions, where you know where you are at any given time in this development. You know, well, I can now do an hour, I can now do 2 hours, and so on. That's what will start to change the balance. And that's what will start to overpower the old habits and replace them with the new. Essentially, this is neuroplasticity, brain reconditioning, operant conditioning. I'll get into all the science on another video, but all you need to know now is this is one of the most proven theories in all of psychology. You can look up the work of Watson and Skinner, and you can also appeal to your own intuition. You already know this stuff. How do you learn a language? How do you learn to play an instrument? How do you learn to drive a car? Whatever. Repetition, 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 engaging in those behaviors. Your performance and productivity is the same thing. You have to habituate this way of being. Repeat it, repeat it, repeat it, just like learning anything. And it will be imprinted into your psychology and you'll actually have it as a behavior, a learned behavior. And at that point, you are able to win the end game and get on with your life. Final piece is thriving from within. You have to change your beliefs to change your life. Get into an abundance mentality, because abundance brings winning emotions of gratitude, of happiness, of health, of vitality. Those emotions attract success because they simply allow you to blast through every obstacle that gets put in your way until you succeed. So that's tremendously important. Now, those are the three pillars of Iron Will. How are you going to apply them and make it work? This is the big takeaway. Just read this slide. This has got everything you need. I'm going to speak to you and coach you through it. But from now on, these are the two keys. These two keys I want tattooed onto the walls of your heart. The two keys are your pathway out of procrastination hell. If you apply these, you will no longer suffer from wasted potential. You will no longer have to, while the years away, asking yourself, why aren't I further ahead? If you're serious about taking charge, doubling your productivity, breaking past your limits, and becoming the version of you this world needs, your two keys here are going to save you. And it's up to you to make it happen. And if you don't after this video, it's your fault, because the help is here. So let's get into it. The first key, brain reconditioning for structured living. Okay. You are going to need to adapt your brain, your procrastinating, frenetic, stressed, anxious, avoidant brain, to being a deep worker. What do I mean by deep work? You have to train your subconscious and install the behaviors and patterns of being able to sit down and focus for hours without inattention and resistance and resentment. You're going to have to train your brain and body to do that. Your nervous system has to be trained. You're going to probably at the start sit down, and every cell in your body is going to want to rip out the chair and sprint down the street. That's how it was for me. You're going to be there tensing up like the Incredible Hulk, ready to blast through walls, because guess what? A stressed biology and physiology is sending signals to the brain that there is a fucking saber-toothed tiger in the room. Get up, get out of here. So that's why there's two keys here. You do have to start sending safety data into the subconscious brain by sitting down and focusing very calmly. Just letting yourself be wherever you are, accepting, letting go, and just reassuring your body, no, we're not in any danger, it's okay. I know you're trying to protect me, but it's okay. I'm in charge, I can deal with it. You don't have to produce this vigilance and resistance. Everything's going to be okay. Trust me, I can handle it. You have to prove to your brain and body that you're the boss, that these resistance and endless task switching that it's trying to produce, which is driven by stress, fear, negative emotions, and uncertainty and lack, you have to convince it that that's not true, that you are able to steer this ship to where it needs to go. You're the captain. You're the pilot. This is your life, and you're the one who decides where you go, not your conditioning. So you're going to have to recondition it and sit there and send the signals to your subconscious brain. I'm okay. Stop fucking with me. Stop pulling me away from where I need to be. Stop limiting me. I need to live my destiny, and I've got it. Okay? So we're now going to start applying structure to our life. 7 days a week at the start to really get this nailed down. Once you've destroyed your procrastination, you can get on with your life. That's fine. But temporarily, as you're fixing this problem, it's a structured way of life. Okay? So to make that happen, you have to start being a consistent person. And what I found in coaching many people through this, we need to start with a day, the approach to one day that is repeatable. So just take it one day at a time. Your day needs to have a consistent rising time and a consistent to bedtime. No excuses. Simple as that. Because once you've got that clearly anchored in, the time in between, as your brain and body heals and your focus comes back and you can sit down and do deep work, we'll be able to optimize that over time. But as a minimum, there needs to be a clear framework for you to recondition yourself and live a more productive life. So nail your bedtime and nail your rising time. 7 days a week, no excuses. During this process, no excuses. Okay. Every day, you're going to be doing deep work. Every day. Okay. I don't care if it's studying a new language, it's playing instruments, or it's whatever the case may be. Every day, we are going to be focusing our brain. Yeah? If you need to develop a new project for yourself, whatever. Ask me if you need some help. Or if you've got a business, if you've got other endeavors, fine. We're going to engage our brain in focused thought. Pull ourselves out of our consciousness and into the world. Get out of the head and into life. Deep work. No distractions. None. And you're going to sit there and build this up. We're going to use the Pomodoro technique. You can look up the Pomodoro technique, but essentially it's a 25-minute timer where you sit down, eliminate all distractions, put your website blockers on, put your cold turkey blocker on, put your phone on airplane mode, 25 minutes of focused, consistent work, and then you can have 5 minutes of break, chill, go for a walk, whatever, and build these up. That's you training your body and brain to do deep work. And you're going to build your Pomodoros up over time. I've had clients who work with me who couldn't do 1 minute of work. And through this, they got to doing really high, consistent levels of performance, right? This aspect is key one. Structure. Structure to recondition your brain. So you're going to have to create a schedule and stick to it. Key number two. Guys, what did I say about what drives this? Do you remember? Stress, inflammation, inappropriate conditioning, yeah? Negative emotions, resistance, all of that. Low energy, brain not working super great, low brain chemistry, drive. Okay? Just doing the structure will only get you so far. It didn't get me all the way. I tried. I did just the structure aggressively for like 2 years. 16 hours a day of work. Still struggled. I didn't know the next piece. Then I figured it out. You have to also heal your cells, heal your nervous system and brain. If you do that, your stress and vigilance levels go down, and then your brain effectively reconditions itself. When you're no longer in the deep stress state, the brain's more apt to lay down new neural pathways. Just how it works. Look up neuroplasticity. The less stress you have, the calmer you can bring your physiology, the more effectively you can rewire your brain. So it's simple stuff. You're going to do this. Ravi's five S's. You're going to watch the sunrise every day. You're going to see the sunset every day. Don't look directly into the sun. You don't need to do nothing like that. If it's cloudy, doesn't matter. All I need is getting the light of sunrise and sunset on your photoreceptors, on your skin, and on your eyes. That realigns your circadian biology, and that gets you able to actually rise earlier and also go to bed at a consistent time every day. It anchors you. That's what you need. Okay? And it also raises your dopamine, starts to heal your cells, optimize your sleep. It's a massive hack that will bring everything together for you so you don't have this problem anymore. So Ravi's five S's: sunrise, sunset, sleep, consistent sleep time, sleep in a pitch black room, turn your Wi-Fi off at night, turn your, all your devices on airplane mode, optimize your sleep. Yeah, that's when your body heals. That's when your mitochondria heal. That's when your brain heals. That's when your brain consolidates memory. That's when you lay down new neural pathways. Anyone who's in my tribe, I and Will, we nail sleep. Everyone. I don't care how wealthy you are, how successful you are. Some of my guys are decamillionaires. I make them go to bed early. Yeah. 10 p.m. Because when you're properly focused and you've healed your brain, guess what? You can move mountains in a few hours. So there's no excuses. None that I'll accept. Okay? Stress. We're going to find ways to see the world differently. We're going to heal ourselves, get that hydration going, consume a lot of DHA. You can follow my stuff. I'll give you a lot of the tips, but also things like meditation, visualization, inner work, journaling, reading, you know, spiritual practices, bringing down the emotional and mental stresses and getting into abundance thinking. You have to get into abundance thinking to be successful, because you need to play the numbers game to be successful. So there's stress reduction techniques that you're going to explore and I can help you with. There's a lot of information I give. And then we've got support. Okay, support. You'll need to make a change, community and connection. The child who is not connected to the village will burn it down to feel its warmth. The lone wolf is taken out by the pack. You can't go on this journey alone. It doesn't work. I have a free group you can join. I have a free forum you can join. And people will back you. You need to have some sort of tribal support. That's why I call this Iron Wall Tribe. Because humans are tribal. It's simply our design. And when you see other people taking action, humans learn not only intellectually, but also socially. In being in an environment that is high performance, where these habits are being done in front of you, you are learning socially. Because think about this. So much of your life, without you really knowing, you learned socially. You weren't specifically sat down and told different things, how to interact with people and how to be. You absorbed it by social learning and social conditioning. You need to leverage that to make a change. You need to find some sort of support, whether it's talking to a friend, whether it's talking to your parents, whatever it may be, an accountability partner. But you need to put real, robust accountability in place to allow yourself to change. And if you do that, you'll win. Okay? So, 30 days to freedom. Bringing all of this together now and summarizing it so you can go out and make a change. 30 days to freedom. To fix this for good. To build a foundation that is unstoppable. I want you to schedule your next 7 days. Okay? I want a consistent rising time and a consistent to-bed time. Within every one of those days, I want sunrise to be seen. I want the light of sunrise to be in your eyes and on your skin. No glasses. I want you to watch sunset every day as well. Same principle. Don't look directly into the sun. You look off. It doesn't have to be bright. It can be cloudy. It can be raining. Whatever. No excuses. Sleep. I want you nailing sleep in a pitch black room with all devices off. Wi-Fi off. Okay? Stress reduction. You can look into meditation, visualization, therapy, journaling, all that. Some form of head work has to be done. And support. Yeah. You're going to need to find some support for this, man. Yeah, you're going to. That's how we change. It just is. That's why I do the work I do as a coach. If you need some support, I'll walk with you. You can email me and you can be coached by me. Or my group is free. You can join the Iron More Tribe Goal Crushing Community. It's free. I also have a forum you can join. Again, it's free. And you can find people in your life. Yeah. Who are going to support you, believe in you, back you, and work with you through the change process and see what comes up and give you space to navigate it how you need to navigate it. So if you structure 7 days and repeat it, and you spend time putting time aside to do the deep work that I recommended, yeah, in a structured way, build your Pomodoros up. So every day you're nailing, maybe you start small with one Pomodoro, you've got the foundation set up, stabilize that, go to two, stabilize that, go to three, four, five. Point being here is in 30 days, we want to see progressive improvements in how many Pomodoros you can do with total focus and clarity. So by the end of it, you've built a variety of new neural pathways, which will overwhelm and push away the pathways of stagnation and all those subconscious loops that without you necessarily knowing lead to you not creating the results that you want in life. You do this for 30 days, you're going to have a new brain, a different life. Enjoy the journey. Let go, accept, feel abundant. You have to love yourself and radiate appreciation for life. Winning comes to those who are grateful, positive, and are a force for good in this world. Finally, this, guys, is simple. If you do this, literally just do this, you'll have a killer 2024. If you apply what you've learned here, you're going to crush it this year. And this will be the year where you finally start to make something special out of your life. For those who learn better through reading, I've written an article on this, which you can check out. I'll post it below. And for those who want to do this work, and I encourage this as a part of the community, join my free Facebook group. I'll post a link for that as well. And for the most serious among you who are ready to really double their productivity, break past their limits, and get really unstuck and into consistent performance in their life, you can join my Peak Performance Coaching Program. It's one-on-one. I check in with you every single day. We have deep contact every single day. We have deep dive calls twice a month for an hour. And we go through the entire Iron Will methodology, self-study program, go through everything together, and we optimize it for your goals. Primary goal, secondary goal, we'll put focus on you getting to where you want to be in terms of your consistency and your performance, and we'll leave no stone unturned to get you there. That is all from me, guys. Ravi, Iron Will, checking out for the day. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video. I'm going to deliver massive, massive value to you. So if you're kind enough to subscribe and show some love to me, believe me, I'm going to be changing your life this year and giving you everything I've learned from 13 years of obsessive research. This is the reason I'm in this world. This is why God put me here. I can solve these things and create unbelievable, stellar client results. And that's what I want to do for you. So go ahead and give me a subscription. Like this video, comment below, and let's win together. To your success, Ravi.